Okay, so welcome back. Like I said, I wanted to start this video on a separate one because it's going to take quite a while to clean up the topology for the door we've just made, and I want to try and get it low poly but really nice. So we're going to start our approach now. So what we're going to do is we're just going to select every, I'm going to press 5 to go into orthographic view, and we're just going to select every edge along the back, and then we're going to merge it on the corner. Do the same thing the other side, and you can see here, if you can see it, the trees at the moment are 3186. We're going to get these down to about 1,000, maybe even less. So again, we're going to merge at last, grab these, and we're going to merge them, and we're going to do this the whole way across. Keeping the overall shape, don't forget. So, merge here. And now we can start to work on this side. Just keep in mind, you need to remember where your edges are. So, we're going to do the same thing again, and we're just going to merge. And we're going to do it right here. No, let's do this side, and then we'll just work our way down. So merge at the last. As you can see, the door's already starting to look a bit cleaner in terms of topology. So I'm just gonna clean up. No, I am gonna, I keep wanting to jump ahead, but I'm not gonna. I'm gonna be a good boy. So I'm gonna select these edges and merge there. Same here. Select these, merge there. And I'm just going to do this side first, just so we have a good eye for where we need to go to. Merge the vertices on the end. Merge here. Merge there. Try not to get confused on where the topology is getting merged as well, because we want to keep this quite less dense. Doesn't make sense, you know what I mean. Right, so I'm gonna move back over to this side now and work across the back here. Merge. And across this back edge. Merge. Now, while I'm doing this, I did start the tutorial earlier, last week, for the brownstone building, but I wasn't sure whether they wanted it modular as an interior modular or exterior modular, so I got about halfway through. Well, I pretty much had the building done, and we were just working on the sort of the exterior. But I just thought I'll do this because this is more this is a lot handier, a lot more helpful. So when we're doing this, what we're going to do is we're going to keep the brick texture separate, and same with the concrete and the windows. And the reason for that is because it's modular, we can move it about quite quickly, and we can also change the materials quite quickly then too. So we should be able to use something that we can use several times. Okay, so here's our first problem. Right, this edge here doesn't seem to be doing anything, so I'm gonna extrude it out, and I'm gonna remove the doubles, and I'm gonna do that there as well. So I'm gonna merge at last. In fact, we might even be able to do that one more. We will. No, we won't. I see what I've just done wrong. There was an extra sort of... No, there wasn't. Okay. I did do that right. That's why this one here. So merge that at last. And now, oh, don't make me angry. So I'm going to merge it back there. And then we're just going to go and merge it across the end. I don't know why this is doing this. Ah, I see why it's doing it. Because of this loop cut here. Is it needed? Not really, no. Okay, so with that done, I'm just going to start to merge these in now. Okay. Bearing in mind we're keeping all the shapes we need. What I want to do is just bring this to the middle. So I'm going to remove the doubles. And I'm going to bring this up to around about there. Now, a lot of these we need, a lot of these we don't. These we don't need. So we're just gonna and this middle one, do we need? Let's dissolve it and see. Okay, no we don't. That's good. Okay. It's got a shape going pretty good. Bring that up to there. Bring that up to there. Same here. I think another thing that I'm going to do is just cut it back in half. Just so we can work on one side again. I think it'll be a lot easier. Now, another thing I want to do is just bring these up. Bring him down. I can see already we've gone down. Oh, we're past 1,000 polys now. So we're doing pretty well in terms of the shape. Now we have to go back into our singular click mode, merge at last. Now we have an issue there, so we need to undo what we just did. And we can't, okay. Luckily, managed to fix it another way. Now, same at the bottom. Make sure we select the right vertices. And then I'm just going to select all of these like so. Merge here, all of these, merge there, and all of these, air merge, there, same at the back, dissolve the edge there, remove any doubles. Now it's all connected up and it's all looking pretty nice. I will, however, want to connect these sides, so I'm just going to add in these vertices. Just to make sure that's connected up properly there. You see, we can get rid of the shading issues. Okay. Right. So we finally finished that part. What we're going to do is just have our cursor selected and we're going to mirror it. I just want to bring this in slightly. I think that it looks a bit too big. Okay, so that's done. We're going to remove the doubles and remove this edge here. Just going to bring these down. Make sure that it's all merged up properly. You see this edge here, we don't need. Just going to remove those edges. And again, remove that edge. Okay. So what are we on now? 1,500. We've halved it. That's pretty good. If I do say so myself. Okay, so we're going to apply the rotation and scale. Make sure the pivot point is at the bottom. Shift and S, cursor selected, origin to 3D cursor. Now very quickly, I'm just going to fix a couple of things. One of those things will be the fact that we're going to want these doors seamless. So while I'm doing that, I'm just going to UV project this brick onto it, see how it looks. So brick large brown, and I'm going to do the same thing. So 3, apply the mirror on that because that's done, move the edges, and looks like we're just going to quickly UV wrap this. So right across the back, one there, right across the bottom, mark the seam, and then we just want to do one more quick one, and then we're going to unwrap that, apply the rotation scale, and then unwrap it. Okay, so we're coming along pretty nice now. We've got our layers done. We've got the top, the middle, and the bottom. We just need to work on the door slightly. I think I am going to do this bit here though. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add an edge split. I'm going to bevel it around about there. Same thing here, edge split, bevel it. And we're just going to do this the whole way so we can make sure it's symmetrical. So again, bevel. When it gets to about there, you know, add another bevel. Gonna bevel this one. Now we're gonna select all the edges and we're gonna bevel the edges. So we're going to do a quick bevel. Do you know what? We don't need the outside edges selected, do we? I just realised that. So we're going to bevel and stop at about there. Keep those faces selected and we're just going to select across the top, bottom and that. And invert, and we're going to extrude in. Give it a small little inset and extrude in again, and now we have our window as well. So the first thing that I would do is add a mirror split. No, because we're going to texture these separately, aren't we? So okay. So, one quick thing is to add in a door frame. Just gonna round about there. Inset again. Delete the bottom faces. Select the bottom vertices, bring them down. And extrude. Move doubles, delete the face, delete the bottom two, move any other doubles, and then we're going to bevel the edge, extrude Alt and S, if not just on one axis, and then we're going to bring it down, like so. And then we have our door frame as well. Now, one thing that I just want to do real quick is just straighten out these edges, because they're really getting on my nerves. So with these edges straight, I'm going to select them both, go back into this view, and I'm going to scale it across. Just to make sure that it's all in. Sweet. Now with that like that, we're done. No, I'm joking. The door we're going to come back to, because we are going to bring that into Substance Painter and texture it in there, because I don't quite like this door. So now all we need to do is work on the top trim. But I'm going to do this differently. So I'm just adding loop cuts in. And then we're really going to start to pull out the topology now and work on this. So scale it out, select that piece and that piece, scale it out. Okay, now here I'm going to duplicate this, scale it in, and extrude out, bring it up. Delete the face. So this is what I want to do. So first thing I'm going to do is just hide that. I'm going to merge these at the center. In fact, no. I think if I bring these back and then bring these back, it might look better. Yep. Okay. And then I'm going to shape it now. So around about here and one there. So what I'm going to do is just bring this back, bring this forward and bevel. So I apply the rotation and scale, and I'm going to bevel. Add another loop cut there. And first thing I'll do is just select that, scale it out. Edge split. So, I'm just trying to get this shape right here. I think a lot of it is just put the vertices in. That looks good. I do want to pull this in too. Maybe give it a bevel. Yeah. Okay. So, how many we got there? Got one, two, and then we want two in the middle. So, one, two. One, two. Now, overall, this looks pretty nice. Looks good. I'm quite happy with that. First thing I want to do is just clean up the topology of this. So, what I'm going to do is hide everything else. Just shift all the edges over to one corner. I'm also gonna mark a seam. Apply the rotation scale and I'm gonna unwrap it. I'm gonna give it the concrete texture. We're gonna want that as a darker concrete though, so we can come back in a second and fix it. Okay, so now I've done that, what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna delete these other ones again. And this one, I'm gonna go in edge select mode. And I'm just gonna select the edges. And then mark seam. Unwrap. Make sure it's using the concrete. And I can reduplicate now, so duplicate around about there. And scale it in. So two there and two there. I think these pieces will look good though if we do sort of bring them in. Now we can test it out, see how it looks. Works quite well. Can also bring it back. And it works all right, it works quite well. One thing I do just want to have a look at. So obviously you've got the stairs and the bottom base. But I'm not sure whether I want to do those. Could do. Another thing we could do is we could take that away. So we could join that as one. But we can also use this as one piece too. So what I want to do there quick is just grab these two. stones, same on the other side. Just do a maiden, sorry. Okay. One more across the top. And we're good to go. Okay, door frame. Make sure all of the bottom is straight and has no faces. Mark the seams. Mark a seam around. And then one on each corner. Unwrap, apply the rotation and scale, then unwrap. And we're going to bring that wood back in, so wood. Same with this bit here, with the window. What we're going to do is we're going to hide every single window pane. Before we do that, mark seam, then hide. So we've got our first seam marked in. And then we're going to just go straight around the back. Mark a seam, and we're going to unwrap. Wood fine. Looks good. The windows have actually stayed in as well, which is looks good. Only issue I have with that though is it's a bit dark. It's a bit light, and our other windows are dark. But all in all, I think bring the doors back slightly. We have the old shape. Across here, we're just gonna unwrap. And we're going to use the concrete texture. And now we've got our front done, I want to do our side. So we can do the same here. We can just duplicate it, bring it to the corner, and have our side. That'll be for an end building, so we're going to work on another side now. So I want to bring that back in, and this is just going to be plain. So I'm going to control and I delete all of that, fill in these faces, and then I want to dissolve the edges. Unwrap concrete. Now, with the concrete unwrapped, sorry, with the concrete. I think two or three could suffice. What I want to do though is I just quickly want to go into the other view and I want to project it so the concrete's different on the side, so it's a bit bigger. Okay. Now I want to see how does it look, and it looks beautiful. So we can sort of seamlessly integrate them as well, and then we could change the textures there. You see. So they don't always have to be sort of straight. You can have like a road that goes like that. But no. Okay, so that's pretty nice. I'm happy with that so far. Couple of things we need to change though. We don't need to do a wall for the opposite side because we have this. However, the back will be the same as the front as well. I just want to hide that, delete these faces because they're not needed. Clean up the topology. Okay, seems pretty clean. Okay. Let's duplicate, and I want to see what it looks like with another texture on it. So I'm going to open up just a brick texture. And the concrete, I'm gonna open up. Like a grey concrete, so. Not that though. It's not like a base, there you go, this'll do. base concrete, and in fact that would look better on the other one just because of the damage through it. So again, I'm gonna just change this to the concrete. Change this to the concrete. That. Brick's already there, isn't it? So brick 2. And then I'm going to change these concretes. And while I'm at the side, I'm going to change that to the concrete as well, just to get it there already. That looks beautiful. Now, I'm not quite ready to bring it into the engine yet, which is why I'm just checking it out, how it looks here. Creep floor. And chase the concrete up here as well. Okay. So see now, I don't think this brown brick works quite well, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the bricks 2. I'm going to replace the image. I have another folder here with a couple of bricks in, so I'm going to have a look here. Well, that looks nice. That's quite good. Really old school. And I'm going to duplicate it again one more time. And I'm going to change this brick texture now. Let's go with the brick new. See how that looks. Brick new. Brick new. Okay. So you see, I've already got three different kinds of like brick on it, and it doesn't look too shabby. You might have to play around with the textures when you get into the engine. Just the UVs, but again, because we're doing this with overlapping UVs, there's not an issue there. So works the same for the doors. We can change the color of the doors as well. Windows will be quite shiny, so I think maybe we can delete that one because we don't need it now. These walls, by the way, we will break them up when we bring them back into the engine, just so we can place them about. The only reason why I did that is just so we could have each piece UV map perfectly to fit each other. So we've done all our hard work now. I'm not sure whether or not I may as well. I was going to say, I'm not sure whether or not I should do like a second layer, you know, the bottom floor, but we're going to have to because we want it to look right, don't we? So what I'm going to do is I'm quickly going to assign all my materials to it, and then I'm going to sort of import the pieces once we've done the base floor. So, let's turn the ambient occlusion off actually, see how it looks about the ambient occlusion. It looked pretty flat. once we get it into the engine, I'm hoping the ambient occlusion does make it look better. If not, we're gonna have to figure out how to do that. Okay, so our next step is to just bring this down. And we're gonna have like a ground floor as well. So first thing we're gonna do is just have our selection to the bottom. And we're gonna create a plane. And then we're gonna add some cuts into it. Around about there. And extrude this down. Delete the outer faces. Bring it down to the ground. And I think what I'm gonna do here is bring it across like so. Oh, you see, this is why I don't like it. So I'm going to leave that like it is for now, and I'm just going to do some steps real quick. So the steps for a brown house is 12. So I'm going to bring that there. Place it on the floor. Put in 12. Scale on the X, scale down every other. And I'm going to change that to 1. Okay. So what I'm doing now is I'm just going to give the overall shape to it. Right, I'm quite happy with them there, so I'm going to apply that array modifier. I'm going to bring it back, and this last step I'm going to bring across to around about there. Okay, now what I want to do is just try and get these steps so that you can get them going up. Oh, is it 180? And I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to bring them down. So we can bring this out to about there, maybe. Bring the steps across. Delete the top two. Now, this is the part what I'm not sure about. So I'm going to bring it down. Okay. Now if it goes down, it's okay. Oh god, I really don't like this part. It just messes with your mind trying to picture how it's gonna look. So let me just first, I'm gonna add another plane, because this is our ground. Our ground is gonna be there. Let's just do it as if that was the street. Well, these parts are going to be modular anyway, so we can sort of like add extra steps to it and whatnot. So, like I said, this part here, let's just imagine that this is the street. So, we've got the street. Now, if we do that, it's fine. But if we were to bring it forward, we have this gap. We have this gap here, too. Okay. Come on, Henry, think. I'm sorry, guys. This is the part where I get stuck at. So we have a sort of building there, and the street coming through. So I know the first thing for definite is this window needs to be brought up. So I'm going to make that a separate piece. In fact, I'm going to delete it. Let that curve carry in. And then from this piece, I'm going to bring up another window. Hide that. So I'm going to duplicate this window down to the bottom. And then we're going to shape the window. So let's get rid of the background again. So now we need to bring this up. Bring this up. Let's have it like there. I want to fill his face in. Move it doubles, there we go. This edge doesn't need to be there, so that can go. Okay. So now we need to focus on the steps. So we need to get sort of this, like the barrier going up. We need to have this arching. We need to be able to go down as well. That's what I'm worrying about, is these steps here going down. Maybe if there were shorter steps. Still have that issue though of coming across here. Okay. So while I'm just trying to focus on what I'm actually doing here, I'm gonna open up my concrete ground just to put it on there for a minute. I'll rotate 90 degrees. Looks alright. Okay. Right, let's just get stuck into it, guys, and see what we can come up with. So I'm going to add a cube. Pivot point at the bottom as usual. Delete the face as well. Origin the geometry, scale it up. So we have it about, I think it's the fifth step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's have it on the sixth step. Okay. And I'm going to put my origin to the middle and I'm going to mirror modify it. And I'm going to duplicate and extrude. Just to get, I just want to get a quick block out of the scene and see what we can come up with together. I'm going to scale it in. I don't mind if it goes into the wall a little bit. Same here, I don't mind if that goes out into the neighbor's garden or whatnot. Okay. That's alright. I just need to duplicate this and make a separate selection because we're going to need another one down here. You can hear me huffing and puffing away because I don't like this bit. I'm going to scale it in on the X. You see now, really, we should have like, where is that image? The brownstones. I'm gonna have a look because you see they've done it different. Ah, okay. Now that helps out a little bit more, doesn't it, guys? Okay, that I can work with. So what we're gonna do. Delete these faces there and see the only issue that I have with that though is you're never going to be able to bring one forward or one back. You'd have to add in extra pieces of the floor or remove pieces if you were to bring it forward. I think what we'll do is we will do that, but then when we work on the modular streets, no, yeah, no. See, the only problems I'm having now is when you have a modular streets, most of the buildings, on the front, like this, they're on the front. Now, if we bring in a modular street, we can bring it across, which would help if we wanted to bring parts back, but then we have to push that back as well, or move the terrain about. It just becomes really hard. I think our best bet is the steps going down as well. So I'm going to delete everything else that we don't need. And we know that that's the shape that we can work with. See, I even saved my step straight away, just jumping into it. Okay. Now we're going to do two different types anyway. We're going to do one with the metal railings, and another one is going to be stone, concrete. So I'm going to delete those and that, and we're going to bring this across. I'm just going to do it the way it is there. We'll work on changing it all about later on. So with that, I'm going to rotate 180 degrees, bring it down. See, our steps are going to need to be wider now. No, they're not. What am I doing? I'm so sorry about this, guys. My brain has just been, like, attacked because of this stupid shape. We're gonna have to have, like, short steps going down. You see, I'm thinking this part here, if we bring it out like so with the steps to around about there, and we bring in these two pieces like so, that would give us a good, and then we can do the same here. Yeah, the only thing I don't like is that though. Okay. Okay, so we got our stairs. Now we're going to bring this down slightly. So we're going to bring it down about there. And then I'm going to remove that. And I'm going to bring this part down here. Down to there. Okay, so we're now working off of this shape. We can now bring this further back. Do is just try and get it so this last step sits there. Now that's not too bad, I'm quite happy with that. If we bring it over, I'll apply that for now. If we bring it over here, okay. We can then put the other one up there. That doesn't look too bad. That looks okay. This first step is going to go anyway, so we're going to delete that. Overall, though, a shape could work. And don't forget where we have the road. I'm going to put the road back in now just to work from. Now that's good, because what we can do is we can also have a copy that goes straight to the road like that. So I think, yeah, these steps do need to be next to each other. So I think I'm bringing that back again. I don't think it works quite like that on the actual picture, but this is how we can make it work. Okay, so let's start working on this anyway. So I'm going to open up an image. I'm going to have to open that up separately now. I think it may be this. No, it's not that. It's something else. So I'm just going to close that. I'm going to try and find a brownstone image. And we should have it. Let's try the desktop. There we go. Okay. Well, that gives me something to work from. So I think one of the problems that I'm having right now is, yeah, it needs to be scaled up a lot more. I'm gonna apply the rotation and scale. I'm going to keep that like it is for now. I can scale that in now. Okay, now that's better. A lot better. I can give it something to work from. Right, let's start on the first one anyway, because we're getting a bit carried away, bumping our heads, trying to sort this out. So, in the picture, they are using railings. However, I want to use concrete and railings. So, I'm going to do the concrete one first. So, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do the... I'm going to hide everything. And I'm just going to work from the image. So I'm going to bring it down and extrude just up for now. Extrude in and then extrude up again. I think I'll bring that in now. Now working off the left side because it's matching up. Through to the Okay. Right. Now I'm going to come back in and do these little bits. So here, I'm going to add it, extrude it in. This one I'm going to extrude out. Make sure I've smoothed it and I've added an edge split modifier. And one more here to extrude out, so I'm just going to scale it up like that. So this one here, now yeah, that looks better. So I want to start bringing this one in now. Yeah, perfect. Now the next thing that I want to do is just, I want to add all the way around. Make sure I have individual origins. I'm going to add an inset. Turn on individual. Well, now with that done, I'm going to extrude out. No, let's extrude in the first one, sorry. So I'm going to extrude in. Extrude in. Do another inset. Extrude out again. Scale it slightly. Another inset, extrude in again, scale, inset, extrude out, scale, and that doesn't look too bad. Let's bring everything back into the scene now. Looks a lot better. We can, if we wanted to as well, is bevel the edges. I'm not gonna, I'm just marking the seams though, so we're gonna mark the seams and just get the concrete on it, see how it looks. Probably use this one here, so I'll take these two seams away. Mark the seam, and one for the bottom. Unwrap. Open up the concrete. Now, I'm going to use the concrete that we're using at the moment. I'm going to do the same with this wall. I'm just going to quickly mark the seams. Give it a quick unwrap. Maybe bevel these edges. Take these two seams and clear the seam. Unwrap again. Okay. Maybe take one of these seams out. So I'm going to take a seam out. I'm going to unwrap it. And that way we can get the flow going over. Only issue I have is this part here. Put the seam back in, try again. Yeah, I think that's a better approach. Now the steps. I jumped the gun a little bit because I was getting a bit excited. So I'm going to add a loop cut all the way through these. Select them all. Now I'm just going to select the faces and extrude out slightly and then give it a bevel. So I extrude. And extrude again and scale on the Z. You can see that worked out quite well. Maybe it went a bit too far though. So I'm going to go back. Extrude slightly. A lot better. So sorry about that. Another thing we can do is just delete the faces on the side, otherwise I was just gonna build up a lot of unwanted vertices. And while we're at the sides, we're just gonna mark the seams. So mark a seam there, one here, and then under each step we're gonna make a seam. And then we're going to unwrap, apply the rotation, and then unwrap. Oh, it really does my head in when it does that. Okay. So give me something pretty nice to go from. Now, one thing we could do is just bring it up. That's better. About there. And now I'm going to delete these steps and whatnot. And I'm going to apply the mirror to this. And to that. Join up the steps. Rotate 180 degrees. And bring them down. I'm going to delete the first step. Now I'm going to delete all of these corners. Fill in the face again. Bring it down to the end. Scale it down a bit. Don't need those edges now. Join up the edge here. Same there. And then I want to duplicate these to the other side. I think the first thing I want to do is just scale this in now. Let's scale it across the bottom. Cursor selected. And then I'm going to scale it down. Bring the step in until the step. So, I want to line these bad boys up. Bring them up. And then bring these two down. Okay. That's a lot better now. I think I want to bring these steps over to the edge here. Because I want to see. If I was to bring this over like so, yeah, I'll probably say about there. And what you can do is just, no, I'm going to keep it like that. Okay, so with that done, I'm just gonna grab this wall here really quick. Duplicate it. Make it a separate piece. And I want to just bring it here. Okay. Right, so that's one. May need to change some of the textures. But that's one. The next one, we can just cover this wall out. We can do railings. But overall, I think we've got the shape what we need in now, so I'm gonna scale this down. Making sure that these walls line up as well. So I'm going to delete again what we don't need. And keep what we do. So we're going to go there. Origin the cursor. And we're going to bring a wall to the end. Now we've got that, all we need to do is the roof. I think I want to change a lot of the pieces about here, so and as well, I think we just want to delete this, and I want to bring this across the back. Perfect, look at that, guys. So with this top, I just want to bring it down, so I want to extrude in, scale it in, and that's going to be bitumen. Then of course we have the top and the bottom. So what I'm going to do is, again, I'm going to join these pieces together, give it an edge split. And I'm going to extrude. Oh, these aren't lined up perfect. Dang it. What I was going to do is extrude. I think, yeah, this will work. So I'm gonna duplicate the top and extrude it across. But you see, another thing as well is we're gonna need to make a corner. For when it's the end. Okay, so no. Right, so I'm gonna delete that, and I am gonna line up these faces seamlessly. So I'm gonna go in my background and I'm gonna line up this face with the edge. So I think now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna link it all together. So yeah, doors don't need to be in there. Everything else linked together. Perfectamongo. Right. So, from the top view, I'm going to grab this side completely. S, Y, X, mine, and 0. And same again with this side, S, X, 0. Now we need to do that again because there was a couple of pieces hidden. So I just want to make sure that I'm getting it right. You see, SX 0. SX 0. Now the back we're going to use the front for. So we don't need to worry too much about that right this second. However, what we now need to do is we need to line these all up together. So what we need to do, I was going to select it from the top, but it won't work. So any middle vertices we don't need either. Just make sure you select all of these vertices. And of course the whole of this back. Okay, now I'm just going to move the building about, make sure all of the pieces have been selected. And it looks like it, apart from this top piece. And then I'm going to press S, Y, and 0. And it should have worked, but it hasn't. S, Y, 0. First of all, turn off individual origins to mediation point, then do it SX0. Perfect. Okay. Now we're going to do the same thing again for the sides SX0. SX0. Right. So now we should have coming together. It's all modular, all fits in perfectly. So what we can do is we can start working on the top. Okay, so I'm going to turn on my edge split just for now, just so I can get it looking a little bit smoother. Also, while I'm here, I'm going to attach all of these together, because this is all one piece. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this in. Because, again, this is another piece. Wall, wall, attach. And now we can bring this forward. Yeah, bring it forward to the street. Okie doke. Right, now we can start to see shape coming on pretty good. We overcame the problems that we had previously. So now we have this nice modular scene set up. It's starting to look really good actually, isn't it? So I'm just seeing if there's any flaws. Because obviously, ignore each corner. And I want to go for maximum realism in terms of how it looks, so a couple of things I'm just going to change. Make sure that the curb is right. I'm also going to add a curb and sidewalk just to make it look that little bit real. So, edge split, smooth. And then here, I'm just going to add a road texture. So, it's not there, it's in objects. So objects, assets, street, road, textures. Here we go. Okay. Not the ones I wanted. However, I do need these, so I'm gonna bring them in now. So sidewalk. Turn off my grid floor because it's in the way at the moment. So another thing I'm going to do is just, let's use two. Go for an American look. Now I'm going to try and reopen the image again. So I'm looking for the road. That's not right. And it must be in my other part, so I'll try again. Sorry guys. That's a specular. There we go. Diffuse. Make it so it's only one side of a road. Then we're going to add our curb texture real quick. Okay. Now, for the purposes of doing this, I am going to change just a couple of colors, just because I'm using several different versions to look at. I just want to change how they all look. So I'm just going to change these to brick. And this one again to another brick. I want to have a look at another one, so here we go. One brick. Do the same with this. We'll change the concrete. Change the side concrete. And just these bits too. I think I may need to remove the doubles. Nope. Ah, that's why. Change that concrete to there. And let's change the middle concrete to something else. So I know here I have another concrete. Where is it? Bump. That's a nice one, that. See now, they all fit in together quite seamlessly. And if we wanted to, say if we wanted to bring this one back, what we could do is just, I'm gonna go a little bit further back. See, now this is what I'm looking for. Because what I can do is duplicate this bring it across. But now we can see what other issues we would need to fix if we wanted to do that approach. So we could do a whole street. But you see, the issues that we would have is like this part here. So we'd need to make like a second piece for like an end piece, so both sides are covered up. And that way we shouldn't get any issues then. Okay, so now we've done this part, we can start to work on the wall. I do apologize for sort of getting lost of track. I just wanted to see how it would look and see what issues further we had. So you saw previously, just working on this ground base was an issue. But now that we've worked on the ground base, we can fix. Any issues that we would have. So if I was to invert this, bring this back in, you would see we create a whole building block out of these. We can also work on like a back garden for the scene, so you could have like the back garden, street, and if I duplicate that across again, grab these pieces, bring them out. You see what I mean? We could start to work on more. So what I'm going to do, guys, I'm just going to take a break because my brain is like going 1,000 miles an hour and I was like, oh, we can do this, you can do that, you can do this. So I'm going to take a break and then I will get back to you. So I'll see you in a minute.